Well, I'm better for me. When I was tough. Okay, let's read. When I was a child.
When I was a child.
I speak as a child.
I speak as a child.
I understood as a child.
I understood as a child.
I thought as a child.
I thought as a child.
But when I became a man.
But when I became a man.
Say with a voice. Say, when I became a man.
When I became a man.
I put away childish things.
I put away the childish things.
Hallelujah. So there's a level and there's a season, there's a time. A childish things must be put away. If you are a man and still you are playing a childish game.
Als je man bent en je speelt nog kinderachtige spelletjes.
You are not a man.
Ben je niet een man.
But you are still a child.
Maar je bent nog steeds een kind.
Amen. When you are thinking is very, very myopic.
Als je denken heel klein is.
Even though you are grown.
Ondanks dat je groot bent.
You are still a child.
Ben je nog steeds een kind.
If you are a husband or a wife.
Als je een man of een vrouw bent. Iemands partner.
Then you are thinking a very childish way.
En je denkt op een heel kinderachtige manier.
But you give your husband or wife a task work to do.
Geef je partner echt een werk om te doen.
Zeg tegen iemand, je moet mature.
Zeg tegen iemand, je moet volwassen zijn.
And the number 18 means maturity.
Nummer 18 betekent volwassenheid.
And I pray to the church.
En ik bid tot de kerk.
Of Holy Ghost Revival Chapel.
Van Holy Ghost Revival Chapel.
And every Christian listening to me.
En elke Christen die naar mij luistert.
It is time for us to act as mature people.
Het is tijd dat wij ons gaan gedragen als volwassenen.
Christians.
Christenen.
Born again, speaking tongues still.
Zij die wederom geboren zijn en in tongen spreken.
It is time for you to act and behave mature.
Het is tijd om te veranderen en volwassen te gedragen.
Amen. The baby thing is over.
De baby kinderachtige dingen zijn voorbij.
Zeg over.
Zeg tegen haar, de kinderachtige dingen zijn voorbij.
That is why I said that anytime you want to marry a man or a woman.
Daarom als je met een man of vrouw gaat trouwen.
And don't sit down to follow the maturity of the person.
En je zit niet om de volwassenheid van dezegene te waarderen.
And you go and take the person because of what you have.
En neem deze persoon vanwege wat hij heeft.
The level of the maturity.
Zonder de level van volwassenheid.
You have a big problem.
Heeft u een groot probleem. Yes.
So be mature. Say to your neighbor, be mature.
Dus wees volwassen.
Even our friendship.
Zelfs in onze vriendschappen.
Moving with the people.
De mensen waar we
mee zijn. If you're moving with somebody and it's what thinking is myopic.
Als je met iemand
bent
met een kleine gedachte. Zwakke gedachte.
If you continue to be with that person,
als je met dezegene blijft,
it's not time for the rest of your life.
Dan heeft het verlies de tijd van je leven.
Look for somebody who is mature in thinking.
Zoek iemand die volwassen is in het denken. Hoe u verder en vooruit kunt gaan.
Someone who God brings something that is not happening.
Dan iemand die naar u brengt wat niet gaat
helpen.
En ik bid dat 2018.
I speak over your life.
Ik spreek over uw leven.
That you shall be mature.
Dat u volwassen zult zijn.
Come on, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You want to be mature.
U moet volwassen zijn.
In all things.
In alle dingen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you have only friends that is around you.
Als vrienden naast u heeft.
They don't think of how you go for what.
En ze denken niet aan hoe u vooruit kunt gaan.
They don't bring a project before the table.
Ze brengen geen projecten op tafel. Om te discussiëren.
They don't bring anything meaningful in your family.
Ze brengen niets waardevol in hun familie.
All the time you
are thinking
about. Parties, parties, this and that. And this kind of thing.
Als u met deze mensen bent.
I tell you that.
En
time is there for you.
Er is een tijd en seizoen. Laat je ogen open zijn.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you meet a woman,
als je een vrouw tegenkomt,
or a husband,
of een man,
and every time the man is buying,
en de man koopt alleen maar dingen.
Sit the person down and say, hey guy.
Zet deze persoon in en zegt man. Je moet volwassen worden.
Because sometimes when you have a lot of things,
man, soms als je heel veel dingen heeft,
even for you to have something to wear, that day you struggle.
Soms om met iets te werken is het een probleem.
When you were in Ghana, our shirt were not struggle.
Was alles een groot probleem.
And one yes. But today you have in abundance.
Maar vandaag heb je
de abundance. That every time for you to come to church, you tell me this shirt is going, this one is
not going. This shirt is not.
Get a better friend. Say to me, I want my friend to change this year.
I want my friend to
know the
challenge.
Many people.
Vele mensen.
I see myself.
himself.
In our village.
In also Dolby.
There was a man.
Was a man.
He didn't go to school.
And he didn't school.
Not even P1.
He was in class A.
Do you know what's called P1?
Basically, what that is.
Primary 1. All of us who are going to P1. Class. Is that someone? Are you aware for P1? Primary 1.
Yes, class.
The man did not enter.
It's not in our eerste klas geweest.
But when he received the Holy Ghost baptism.
Maar toen hij de Heilige Geest doop ontving.
And the Bible, the Bible.
En hij nam de genezen Bijbel.
Read the Bible.
Hij las dit.
All of us who are going to school.
Wij die allemaal naar school zijn gegaan.
The way he was reading.
Wij konden niet aanschouwen hoe hij aan het lezen was.
I didn't understand this yet.
Ik begreep deze dingen niet als een kind.
But I tell you, the Holy Spirit is real.
Maar de Heilige Geest is echt.
Oh, so hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The anointing is real.
The salvation is echt.
So don't allow your fleshly minded word to dilute and destroy.
Dus laat de normale gedachten jou niet vernietigen en verleiden. Dat het jou zo groot zou maken.
I remember.
Ik herinner me.
I didn't know that the Holy Ghost was at work.
Ik wist niet dat de Heilige Geest aan het werk was.
When I was 6 years.
Toen ik 6 jaar was.
In our village.
In onze dorp.
Me and my, one of my father's nephews.
Een van mijn vaders neefjes. Hij kon niet echt goed spreken.
So he would do the preaching.
Dus hij ging prediken.
And I too, when he stopped, then I continued.
En als hij stopte, dan ging ik.
And you don't know where. It is going.
En we wisten niet waar het naartoe zou gaan.
So why did you all this thing? Because
dus als je dit verhaal
was a strong, and my family was strong Methodist.
Want mijn ouders waren sterke
Methodist.
Alles wat zij deden in het huis.
It's the oil that they have left in the house.
Is vanwege de olie wat zij in het huis hebben gelaten.
Come on,
en
is
aan het gekomen. Yeah. Hallelujah.
So.
Dus.
The oil and the presence of God.
De olie en de aanwezigheid van God.
Would mark you.
Het zal u markeren.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And wherever you go.
En waar u ook naartoe zult gaan.
The oil will never depart from you.
Zal de olie nooit van u weggaan.
Hey, say to your neighbor that if you can accept, you need the oil.
Zeg tegen je naast, als je verder gaat, heeft de olie nodig.
Let the garment be your always white. And let the head not know ultimate. Come on, shout
hallelujah.
Psalm 92 verse 10.
Psalm 92 verse 10.
Can you read for me? Psalm 92 verse 10.
Psalm 92 verse 10.
But my home.
But my home shall always not like the horn of a bee. I shall be anointed with fresh oil.
I said. He said, my horn, let us say my horn.
My horn.
Shall you up?
Shall
down your exalt. Like the horn of God. I shall be anointed with what? Fresh oil. Let us say fresh oil.
Say fresh oil.
Oh, come on, say fresh oil.
Say fresh oil.
So every time as a child of God,
okay,
you need fresh oil over your life.
Only known over belief.
We are not excelling.
Wij konden niet vooruit.
We are not going forward.
We gaan niet vooruit.
Because we lack fresh oil.
Omdat wij tekort hebben aan fresh olie.
Sometimes some people say that it is Old Testament.
Sommige mensen zeggen het is de Oude Testament.
You are making a mistake. Check your Bible.
Je maakt een fout. Controleer je Bijbel.
Check your Bible.
Controleer je Bijbel.
Exodus 30:1.
Exodus 30 vers 1.
Exodus 30:1.
Exodus 30 vers 31.
So the oil of God.
Dus de olie van God.
Is very, very important.
Is heel erg belangrijk.
You need the oil.
U heeft deze olie nodig.
Zeg, I need the oil.
Zeg, ik heb de olie nodig.
It simply means you need the presence of the Lord.
De
olie is een symbool.
De olie is een symbool.
And you need it.
En u heeft het nodig.
Come on, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Exodus 30:31. And thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel, saying, this shall be an holy anointing oil unto me throughout your generations.
Verse 31.
Verse 31. And thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel, saying, this shall be an holy anointing oil unto me throughout your generations.
And thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel, saying, this shall be an holy anointing oil unto me throughout your generations. Eh? Mm. And that's what said, Lord. This is okay, go to 30.
30. And thou shalt anoint Aaron and his sons.
This is what I want. He said, God spoke to Moses. Everybody, God spoke to Moses.
God spoke to Moses.
And said, thou shalt anoint what?
Aaron and his sons.
Aaron and his sons.
And his sons.
And consecrate them.
That they may minister unto me.
That they may minister unto me.
In the priest office.
In the priest office. So, for you to serve.
Just unto dinner.
In the house of the Lord.
In the house of the Lord.
You need the anointing oil.
Have to the south and the holy Lord.
So, this was Old Testament.
It was Old Testament.
So, it was a symbol of the emblem of what? The Holy Spirit.
A symbol from the hand
of the Lord. But that time, the Holy Spirit has not appeared.
Was the hand of the Lord.
So, this was a symbol.
This was a symbol.
For in waiting.
In a what?
For the Holy Spirit.
From the hand of the King.
Come on, shout hallelujah. So, the oil of the Lord.
Does the oil from the hill.
It's very, very important in your life.
It's belonging in your life.
Amen.
Amen.
When you go to 26.
As you can say 20 hands.
26 to
29.
26 to 29. And thou shalt anoint the tabernacle of the congregation therewith, and the ark of the testimony, and the table and all his vessels, and the candlestick, and his vessels, and the altar of incense, and the altar of burnt offering with all his vessels, and the laver of him, and the laver of his food.
So the Lord told Moses.
Does the Lord say to Moses?
To anoint tables. That was the tables.
And tables Satan.
Tables.
Tables.
Vessels. Altar. Everything. Anointed.
And his own
for what? When you go down,
he
said that, so that everybody who will come and touch it,
so that the even people
that are will be holy.
That is in the hand of our saying.
And thou shalt sanctify them.
Thou shalt sanctify them.
That they may be most holy.
That they may be most holy.
Whatsoever touches them.
Whosoever touches shall be holy.
Even the honored.
Come on, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So in the Old Testament,
in the Old Testament,
God told them what to anoint everything.
So I thought they had that all supposed to solve.
Well, you may choose not to anoint it now.
You may choose not to anoint it now.
Because of the
Holy Spirit.
So if you are a pastor and you don't believe that, and the other pastor believe that,
and the other pastor believe
that, if you are a son of God and you don't believe that, and the other person believe it,
and the other person believe it,
let the person go ahead and apply the oil. Our belief is not in the oil.
Also, for love is not in the oil.
But the application of the oil.
My application from the oil.
Brings the presence of the Lord.
It's a symbol.
That the presence of God comes over you.
And this head for over
the woman. When the oil touches over your head.
That when the oil pulls.
And somebody falls down.
And even falls.
It is not the oil that makes the presence fall.
It is not the oil that makes
the presence
fall.
But it is the presence of the Lord.
It is the unveiled head for the
woman.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
So,
this,
the oil is there.
The oil is there.
In the Old Testament.
In the Old Testament.
Eh? For sanctification.
For untermine.
That is why anybody that invites you to go and dedicate the house.
Dus als het even mij uitnodigt om het huis te voor te brengen.
I ask you.
Naar God.
And I need the house.
En ik vraag het huis.
If you want it.
Of je het huis wilt hebben.
You don't want it.
Als je niet wilt hebben.
But for the fact that you don't want it.
Maar het feit dat je niet wilt hebben.
That don't mean that it doesn't work.
Betekent niet dat het niet werkt.
Come on, shout hallelujah.
So, hallelujah.
Check most of Christians.
Bij christenen.
And check all the churches.
En kijk alle kerken.
Who are seriously preaching against the way of the Lord.
Die prediken tegen de olie.
Check your life.
Kijk hun levens.
Check where they have preached.
Kijk waar ze zijn en wat ze hebben bereikt.
They are limited.
Ze zijn kleine kerken.
They are sent to the Lord.
En klein in
de
ik hoop dat je ogen
opgeopend
zijn.
It is not false.
Et es nid obtrang.
And somebody lacks.
As you need build that iman.
Don't use your unbelief to dilute the person.
Verblendet je ongeloof om diegene.
Hallelujah. You know, for you to receive the oil of the Lord.
You must do
what
you
must do.
So to
help you do it. I say you must do
what.
Come on. I say you must do what. Create it. If you want to please the people.
As you mention
the oil of God.
Only for what?
You will lack it.
So if you are afraid
for how people criticize you,
as you bang over who messes so
by the eye of the Lord,
or for the only fan,
you shall matter.
That's how you take things.
If you are afraid
as you
of what people will say,
what messes
by the application of the
eye
of God,
for the
life, you matter in the Christian race. Come on, shout
hallelujah.
2018. You need the oil.
Hey, the oil, you know.
My son, you know what?
My son,
when I was telling
you,
the Lord opened my eyes.
Open the heart
and I saw Holy Ghost revival.
And it's a Holy Ghost
revival.
And it's a great
thing. That's meditation.
The meditation. Yeah,
what is the meaning of the Holy Ghost?
What is the betekenis van de Heilige Geest?
Holy Ghost.
Heilige Geest.
Holy Ghost tell us.
Holy Ghost tell us.
Must look different.
And look anders eruit.
Holy Ghost tell us.
The Holy Ghost tell us.
Must look in the power of the Holy Ghost.
Moet bewegen in de kracht van de Heilige Geest.
Holy Ghost tell us.
Holy Ghost
tell us. Because of the name.
Vanwege jullie naam.
Must begin to do signs and wonders.
Moet wonderen en
zien. Holy Ghost tell
us. Holy Ghost
tell us. Must not be an ordinary church.
Moet niet een gewone kerk zijn.
Holy Ghost tell us.
Holy Ghost tell us.
Should be different from Pentecost church. From Pentecost church.
From
African church.
From
all the churches. Because what you believe is not what you're building.
Oh, that what you love is not what you're
building. This church was born.
Deze kerk was geboren.
Out of the revival of the Holy Spirit.
En de opwekking van de
Heer. This church was born.
Deze kerk was geboren.
Out of the oil of the Lord.
En de olie van de Heer.
I tell you, I'm not doing that.
Ik kom je aankomen.
Let the immaturity put aside.
See the power of the Lord.
You are not ready to go with us.
U kunt niet gaan.
We shall leave you behind.
We zullen u achterlaten.
So where I am going?
Waar ik naartoe ga?
You don't know. You don't have idea.
Weet je niet en heeft geen idee.
I'm saying to myself, Lord.
Tegen mezelf gezegd.
Take me to the higher level.
Breng me naar een hogere level.
What about you take me to go?
Waar u mij naartoe brengt?
Take me to the higher level.
Breng me naar een hogere level.
Come on, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, your God.
Holy van God.
Me myself.
Ikzelf.
Many people.
Vele mensen.
I have given them oil.
Hebben de olie ontvangen.
Sometimes some people come to me.
Sommige mensen naar mij
komen. And I put the oil in water.
En zet de olie in water.
Said, drink it.
En ik zeg drink het.
Me and Dennis went to Nigeria.
Ik heb in Nigeria.
The way Nigeria people are crazy with anointing.
Hoe de Nigeriaanse mensen gek zijn op zalving olie.
After I have anointed over 1,000 people.
Nadat ik meer dan 1,000 mensen heb gezalfd.
I was exhausted.
Was ik zo.
The man of God took me to the office.
Nam de man van God mee naar de
I kamer. Saw people coming.
En ik zag mensen komen.
Following me. With empty passport.
En ze brachten lege paspoort.
Nigeria passport without visa.
Nigeriaanse paspoorten zonder visa.
Man of God, touch it with your
hand. En ze zeggen, raak het aan met uw olie.
How come that?
En ik zeg, hoe kan dit?
You don't have visa.
Je hebt geen visa.
Ze zei, I believe that you can see it wrong.
Ik geloof dat
I know.
Maar ik weet.
Go make a way.
Dat God een weg zal maken.
There are some things you can't open the door by your mind.
Er zijn dingen die je kunt openen.
You need the presence of God.
Je hebt de aanwezigheid van God nodig.
Come on, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The oil of the Lord.
De olie van God.
Keep this.
Maak er geen grappen mee.
I remember.
Ik herinner mij, jaren geleden.
When as a Methodist.
Toen ik naar Methodist ging.
And the revival movement.
En de opwekking is een beweging.
Fellowship in the church.
En we beginnen te
and the power of the
kerk. En de
kracht van de kerk. Heel veel mensen
kwamen naar ons.
Why are you going from your church?
Waar ga je naar je kerk?
I'm not going anywhere.
En ik zei, ik ga nergens.
All of us, he's telling you're not going anywhere.
En we besloten om nergens heen te
gaan. One day,
omdat
me and my friend is done in Canada.
Kwam een vriend van mijn
huis.
We gingen naar het huis.
Of my friend's sister.
Van de zuster van mijn vriend.
She has a daughter, 2 years old.
En ze had een 2-jarige dochter.
She's called Odin.
Ze heeft ontdekt.
Now she has grown.
Nu is een grote
dame. And the girl was having a running stomach.
En ze had een ze lopen op diarree.
I told the woman, can you bring me water?
En ik zei, kunt u water brengen?
I just prayed over the water.
En ik bad hierover.
You know, I was naïef in these things.
Ik was naïef in deze dingen.
So So what prompted me?
Dus wat mij bewoog?
To pray over the water.
Om over het water te bidden.
And give it 2 years.
Om het aan 2 jarige meisje te
vragen.
Ze droomt dit.
And then.
En ze was te pijnlijk bezig. Ik was naïef, dus ik begreep dit niet.
But when you got to know all these things,
maar als je al deze dingen te weten komt, ik zat zelf al iemand voor alles erin gezet. Ik begreep deze dingen.
Because where I was coming from, we are preaching against it.
Maar waar ik vandaan kwam, spraken we
over.
Maar ik bad erover.
And something happened.
Iets gebeurd.
Come on, shout hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Look at my daughter.
Kijk naar mijn dochter.
Mama, come. This one called
me. Deze vrouw had mij gebeld.
She came to the church after 3 months.
Ze kwam 3 maanden geleden naar de
kerk.
En ze ging terug naar Suriname.
Since then she has been coming to the church of the
time. En sinds dat kwam ze naar de kerk toe.
She came to me.
Ze kwam naar mij.
She's a man of God.
Ze is een man van God.
Papa.
Papa.
It's not wrong time I've seen, but I've seen the Spirit going up to you.
Maar ik heb een geest gezien wat er niet is.
Family,
ik ga naar mijn familie Suriname.
Can you pray and give me oil?
Kunt u van mij bidden en olie geven?
She brought an oil.
Ze bracht een olie.
I missed it with the oil from Jerusalem.
Ik had een gemis met olie van Jerusalem. Ik had van haar gebeden.
I brought her to the house.
Ik bracht haar naar het huis.
She said, go.
En ik zei, neem het en ga.
She called me 3 days ago.
Ze belde mij 3 dagen
geleden. But when she went to Suriname.
Dat toen ze in Suriname
was. What the oil have done in his family.
Wat de olie heeft gedaan in haar familie.
Tomorrow,
next, volgende week zal ze misschien
gevolgd. Don't limit it. Don't limit it.
Limiteer het niet.
Don't use your natural mind.
Gebruik niet je normale gedachten. Om te vernietigen.
The things of the Lord.
De dingen van de Heer.
That's what Paul said.
En daarom zei Paulus.
Eh? The things in the spirit are what? Foolishness.
De dingen in de geest zijn dwaasheid.
To them that what?
Voor zij die.
The oil.
De olie.
In the olden time.
In de oude tijden.
Somebody said that it didn't work.
Iemand zou zeggen het werkt niet.
It is past.
Het is in het verleden.
Our belief is not in the oil.
Ons geloof is niet in de olie.
But we know that by the application.
Maar wij weten door het
gebruiken.
De kracht daarachter.
Zal het
werken.
Come on, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In the book of Mark.
In het boek van Marcus. Ik heb heel veel dingen hier, maar vanwege tijd.
The book of Mark.
In het boek van Marcus.
In the time of Jesus Christ ministry.
In de tijd van de bediening van Jezus. Gebruiken ze olie. Ze gebruiken olie.
Marcus 6.
In Marcus hoofdstuk 6.
Jesus called his disciples.
Riep Jezus zijn discipelen.
En zei en commissioned them.
En hij zei tegen hen.
Read from verse 12, because of time. The beginning is talking about Jesus calling the 12.
En misschien vertellen over hoe Jezus de discipelen bijeen.
Verse 12 and 13.
And Mark chapter 6, verse 12 and 13. And they went out and preached that men should repent. And they cast out many devils and anointed with oil many that were sick and healed them.
What was the time of Jesus?
What was the time of Jesus?
Was it the Old Testament?
Was it the Old Testament?
No, it wasn't the Old Testament. No. Jesus called his four disciples.
Jezus riep zijn discipelen.
And commissioned them to go and preach.
En vertelde hen om te gaan preken.
And what? And cast out demons.
En om demonen weg te jagen.
And after they have cast them.
En nadat zij dit hebben gedaan.
They anoint them.
Moeten zij zalven.
With the oil.
Met olie.
May you receive the oil of the Lord.
Moet de olie van de Heer ontvangen.
So don't allow anybody to tell you that. Come on, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
After the baptism of the Holy Spirit.
Eh? Doop met de Heilige Geest.
In the book of Acts chapter 5.
In de boek van Handelingen
chapter 5. James chapter 5. James. The brother of Jesus.
De broeder van Jezus.
The pillar. The fourth pillar of the church.
De vier pilaren van de kerk.
James was one of them.
Hij was één van hen.
He will commission the church today.
Hij heeft ook de kerk gemaakt vandaag.
James chapter 5, verse 14 and 15.
James 5, 14 and 15. Is any sick among you?
Is any sick among you? Ask somebody.
Is er iemand ziek onder u? Vraag je naasten.
Is anybody sick among you?
Is er iemand ziek onder u?
Let him call for the elders of the church.
Let him call the elders of the church.
And let them pray over him.
And let him pray over him.
Anointing him with the oil in the name of the Lord.
Anointing him in the oil of the name of the Lord.
And the prayer of faith shall save them.
And the prayer of faith shall save. So, when I call you,
it's also for you.
And I take the oil.
And ignite the oil.
And I'm putting on you.
And accept it on you.
It is not the oil.
It is neither oil.
It is a symbol is of a the presence of the Lord.
And this place from here.
So when I apply the oil.
Because when I need the oil.
And I pray behind it.
And it beat behind
the answer. Prayer behind the oil.
And it's a bit
So we are not in the oil.
Let's say live in the oil.
That is not our total belief.
That is not also total
our
belief.
Our belief is in Jesus.
Also, Allah is in yes.
But we shall never reject the application of the oil.
That by the oil in life
shall be
blessed.
Hallelujah. So the care of the Holy Ghost.
There's a care for the Holy Ghost.
If you want to be a different among your brothers.
As the angels will say unto us.
I have seen men of God.
They kept
men
of God.
Who are great men.
Die groot zijn.
They didn't even know how to speak English.
Ze wisten niet hoe ze Engels moesten spreken.
But now when they are speaking.
Maar nu als ze praten.
Cause the oil.
Vanwege de olie.
Something happened.
Gebeurt er iets.
Wat zeg je? I never thought that I can stand before people.
Ik had nooit gedacht dat ik voor mensen kon staan.
I have worked for God.
Ik heb echt gewerkt voor God.
I never thought.
Maar ik had nooit gedacht.
In our fellowship.
In ons samen.
They called me false. Because I was Philistia.
Ze noemden mij daarom dat ik.
And they put their hands on me.
En ze hebben hun hand op mij gelegd.
That you have to be the secretary of this.
Dat u de.
Because anytime they are coming out.
Als ze kwamen, rende ik weg. En nu zijn ik voor de mensen.
And from that time.
En vanaf die tijd.
For the spirit came over me.
Van de moed over
so
mij.
From that when I became crazy the spirit.
And the family.
Because my nature.
Van mijn natuur.
I'm very quiet.
Ben ik heel stil.
Ask my wife.
Vraag mijn
vrouw. When I'm in the house.
In the house.
It's highly for me to talk.
Is it?
But when the oil of God comes over me.
Maar wanneer de olie van God over
me. Ben ik
maar als een leeuw.
You receive the boldness.
U krijgt moed.
To kill the undo.
Om dingen te doen.
Come on, shout hallelujah. Don't underestimate it.
Onderschat de olie niet.
And stop criticizing, talking against it.
En bekritiseer en praat niet tegen de olie.
If you don't like it.
Als je niet van houdt.
Don't be super spiritual.
Wees niet uber spiritueel.
Halleluja.
Halleluja.
I see women.
Ik heb vrouwen.
Who are not giving birth.
Die.
They wake up in the bed.
Ze worden wakker in de bed.
No pastor is there. Pastor is there.
Pastor
daar die hun bijna zeker
met olie.
Maar
Thomas,
receive the word of God.
Dat woord van God moet ontvangen.
This time,
en ja, maar deze tijd zullen we zullen zijn.
Whether you like it or not.
Of jij hiervan houdt of niet.
Pray.
Biddend. Met olie. In de
maar de Bijbel zegt dat.
Maar de Bijbel zegt dat.
En God zegt, I have found David.
God zegt, ik heb
David. Kom maar, halleluja.
Ik heb David gevonden.
With my holy oil.
Met mijn heilige olie.
You may know me all right.
Je kan me kennen.
But the Lord has found me.
Maar de Heer
heeft me. Come on, shout hallelujah. So I want you to take this serious.
Dus ik wil dat u dingen serieus neemt.
Stop all this gossiping by barking. Put it aside. And say, I am ready to receive the oil of
the Lord. En ik ben bereid om de olie van God te ontvangen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.